Why is she telling me what to do?
Very calm?
So warm.
Yes, it is. Don't need no sweater windbreaker for me.
I love that.
That's on my bucket list. As soon as you're well enough to not hurt, you learn how to do one tango with me. Nothing bouncy like a polka or
tango's highly overrated.
No, it's not. You can probably do square line square dancing again. You shuffle your own top.
Time we got? Huh?
12 on the road.
Hey, let's go.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Right.
Yeah.
Welcome to beautiful downtown Savannah, Forsyth Park, and for the 2013 Greening of the Fountain Ceremony. My name is Fred Elmgren, and I'm going to be your master of ceremonies this afternoon. All official functions of the St. Patrick's Day Parade Committee begin with a prayer and a pledge. In order to get that started at this time, I'm going to ask for the Grand Marshal, the Executive Committee of the Parade Committee, and the rest of the folks that are with them to please come forward.
Waters here, every fountain in Savannah that's going to be turned green, that the
green blood that runs through so many in Savannah, including myself. God bless it and you. This we pray in Christ's name. Amen.
And Savannah is a city deep in rich military tradition. Over the years, her sons and daughters have gone off to war to protect this country so that we can be here today and to gather for this great celebration. At this time, I'm going to ask Staff Sergeant, United States Marine Corps, James A. Ray, to please come forward and lead the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please, everybody, put your right hand over your heart. A beautiful day, a beautiful flag that represents the United States of America, the state of Georgia, the Chatham County, and Savannah, Georgia, and all of you. I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
At this time, I would like for the rest of the adjutants, the rest of the aides to the Grand Marshal and the officers and executive committee of the parade committee to please come into the fountain so we can do the greening of the fountain.
Who is the Grand Marshal? The guy who walked the parade first? The head? The guy with all the flower and jewelry on him? Honey, come on up here. The shorter people.
Hey, Billy. How are you?
Well, I've got a good view. I can see
fine.
Are you all ready to see the mount turn green?
Yay!
This time, I will ask Grand Marshal Jimmy Ray to start the process during this mountain.
I think it's that white man.
Next poet for today is going to be Father Smith, and he has along with him the winner of the WTLC coloring contest, Thomas King, who will now pour. The second female aide to a Grand Marshal, Nancy Ray Johnson. Brother to the Grand Marshal, Mr. Charlie Ray. Another brother, Billy Ray. Are we green yet?
No.
I got my granddaughter Katie here. She's supposed to tell me as soon as the fountain turns green. You gonna tell me? Mr. Bruce Arnsdorf, Grand Marshal's aide, past adjutant of the parade. Is it green yet?
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's see if the Italians can turn the Irish fountain green. Come on, Charlie Russo. All right, we got to go to our past chairman. And maybe we can get the fountain to turn green. He's got some help. We got, who you got with you, Joe? His grandson, Miller Sadie. Come on, Miller, let's see if you can get the fountain to turn green. Oh, gosh. It's coming, I promise you, folks. Let's go around here, Katie, and see if Mr. Sheehan can get it to turn green.
Got this.
Brendan said he's been in charge all year long, so it looks like we're going to have to let him make this happen. Brendan Sheehan, General Chairman of the St. Patrick's Day Parade Committee. Who you got with you, Brendan?
I got my son, Declan. I got Stephen Halligan and Henry Walsh.
All right, well, let's see what can happen here. We've got three of you guys. You ought to be able to turn it green. Let's see what happens. Whoa!
Welcome out next year. Have a good day. Have a good day.
great parade for everyone. Come on down and enjoy it.
No, I got a sticker in my room. I'm in the room.
Let it go.
All right, next I've got Frank Baker and Bob Edgley here. And I know we've got somebody here to help pour. Who we got, Bob? Next, okay. Next Friday afternoon, Frank will be heading up the Jasper ceremony downtown. And we look forward to that every year. Make sure you mark your calendar for 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Now we got to the Fogarty play. John.
I have my children with me today from St. Peter the Apostle School. Maggie Fogarty and from Fogarty Hospital.
And last but not least, this is the guy that's in charge of all the bands for the parade. I think he's probably got about 112 of them lined up this year. No, not this year. Tell us a little bit about your bands and who you've got with you, and let's pour some green dye.
Every one of our bands is going to be high quality. They're going to love being here. And I've got my granddaughter, Addison, with me. And she's significant because she is the Corrigan family's first native saint.
All right, welcome. All right, Madison, you know what to do. You've done this before. This ceremony has become not just about the green, this ceremony has become about the kids. And today we're real happy to have some groups over here on my left. I think it's almost the whole school. We've got Notre Dame Academy. Let's hear it for the kids from Notre Dame Academy. Over here on my right, I've been doing this ceremony for 13 years now, I think. And I believe all 13 of those years we've had a class from St. Peter's here. And we've got the kindergarten and first graders from St. Peter's with us today. Now, normally, in the past, we've had them sing a song for us. But today we've got something special. Nicole's the poem, and Graham Woodkowski. They have a birthday today, and I want everybody to sing happy birthday to Nicole and Graham. Happy birthday to you. This fountain green. He's gotten a whole lot more done this year as the general chairman. How about a few words from you, Mr. General Chairman?
Thank you, Fred. Ladies and gentlemen, everybody knows that once we turn to fountain green, it's only a week away from St. Patrick's Day. We have a lot of wonderful festivities going on. I want to thank everybody on the executive committee and the Grand Marshal and all his aides for the wonderful job everybody's done. Oh, and of course, Stephen Halligan, we've got to give him credit. When y'all come out, we got plenty of events. We got Care Fest, we got Celtic Cross, several events next week. The last thing I'd like to say is happy St. Patrick's Day.
Thank you very much. And this guy is not very talkative. When they take him out in public, they have to prompt him to say something. So I want you all guys to kind of help me prompt our Grand Marshal and see if he's got a few words for us. Jimmy?
Okay, guys. Isn't it a beautiful fountain today with the sun sparkling on? Great job. Great job. And like you said, this isn't just for the adults. This is mainly for all the young people and the kids here today. I hope everybody's having a good time. Are all the kids having a good time? Let's hear it. You know, tomorrow is Parafest down on Bay Street in Emmett Park. You need to go by there because it is so much fun for all you kids. They do face paintings, they have food, they have dancing and singing. So I hope you all can attend tomorrow. It looks like we're going to have a beautiful day for that. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Mr. Grand Marshal. This is all about something called St. Patrick's Day in Savannah. At this time, I'd like to ask Mr. Joe Eberwine to come join our Grand Marshal and lead us in the singing of It's St. Patrick's Day in Savannah. And we got a guy that's been doing it since day one. Baby boy over there has been doing this since 1985. Let's hear it for Baby Boy. In years past, ladies and gentlemen, we have planted a commemorative tree right after this ceremony. This year, the tree planting is going to be down in Emmett Park, and it will happen on Sunday as part of the Celtic Cross ceremony. This has been a wonderful ceremony today. At this time, I'm going to ask the chaplain of the St. Patrick's Day Parade Committee to give the benediction.
So that's a Catholic kid?
You've done a wonderful job.
Is that a Catholic?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, what a great day the Lord has given us to be here today. The beautiful sky of Jordan to Delia, the 4,500 feet up here, so we have to have testing. And may he bless not only us here today, those who could not be with us, all those who will be coming to our city. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he look upon you with kindness and always give you his peace, joy, and happiness. Amen. Bless you, Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, come upon you forever and ever. Amen. Our love and bless.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Happy St. Patrick's Day.